Welcome to the Hearing Health Center Video Library, the most complete and helpful online collection of news, instructions, the latest developments, and important information about hearing health. If you want to keep up to date, scan the QR code or click the subscribe button, and we'll notify you of every new release. I hope you watched the What is an Audiogram video that explains the beep tests you take and plots the chart of your hearing ability. If you did, you know that the audiogram just tells us if your hearing is normal or below normal at all the different pitches. It doesn't tell us anything about your brain's ability to process, interpret, and make sense of the sound it receives. Patients often ask, "What caused my hearing problem?" I want to show you how we hear and what can go wrong. There are three parts to your hearing: your outer ear, your middle ear, and your inner ear. Your outer ear consists of the ear itself, your ear canal, and your eardrum. All sound is vibrations that come into your ear, go down your ear canal to your eardrum. The only purpose of your outer ear is to catch the sound. You don't hear with your ears. The sound waves start the vibration of your eardrum, which sends the vibrations to your middle ear. It has the three smallest bones in your body. You learned these in grade school as the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup. These bones vibrate and send the vibrations to your inner ear, and then up the path of the auditory nerve to your brain. The inner ear is your actual organ of hearing. It's called the cochlea, and it looks like a snail and has millions of tiny hair cells all around it. These tiny hair cells vibrate in response to sound and send the sound up the auditory nerve to your brain. So, let's look at what can go wrong. Your ear catches the sound waves, and it's sending it down your ear canal. But there's wax here. The sound can't get through. We take the wax out of your ear, and the sound can continue down the path to your eardrum, which should start your eardrum vibrating. But what if your eardrum has a hole in it? It can't vibrate and send the sound to your middle ear. Holes in the eardrum or perforations often heal themselves. If not, it can easily be patched by the doctor. Now sound goes to your middle ear, and these little bones should start to vibrate. But what if there's fluid in here? Fluid in the ear is the number one reason for pediatric visits. It's the most common ailment in childhood. Fluid often clears up on its own. Sometimes it needs antibiotics, and sometimes the doctor has to put a little hole in the eardrum to drain out all the fluid. So far, everything I've shown you is caused by a blockage from the outer ear to the inner ear. The sound can't get through. All of these blockages can usually be fixed medically or surgically. If this path is clear, then the sound vibrations reach your inner ear, your organ of hearing. What can go wrong with your inner ear? The number one cause of hearing loss is from noise, not age. Many of the sounds you hear every day, all the time, are loud enough to cause damage. Noise damages these tiny hair cells. They get weak or they die. Some people have tougher hair cells than others. Mine might die more easily than yours, and how tough they are or aren't tends to run in families. So if your parents and grandparents had hearing loss, there's a good chance you will too. The beep test we do tells us how much damage there's been to your hair cells. The more damaged and dead hair cells you have, the worse your hearing is going to look on that audiogram. When the hair cells are damaged or dead, they can't send the correct message up the auditory nerve to the brain. Less and less information is going up the auditory nerve, and after a while, it starts to narrow. It's not being used. That's permanent damage that can't be fixed. The nerve can no longer send as much information as it used to your brain. It's your brain that processes, interprets, and makes sense of the vibrations it receives. If your brain is only getting partial information, it can't interpret it or make sense of it. Your brain works really hard to get it. In fact, it's working so hard to try and understand that it's often not transferring information to your memory. Finally, the brain just gives up and stops trying anymore. 95% of all hearing problems occur here. There's no medicine or surgery that can fix this. The only treatment is hearing aids. This is why the Alzheimer's Association recommends that everyone over the age 50 get a baseline hearing evaluation. Treating hearing problems early is the number one modifiable risk factor you can control in preventing and delaying dementia. When you stimulate the hair cells with amplification, it stops them from dying. The stimulation keeps that auditory nerve open for the information to get to your brain. And now your brain is getting the right stimulation. It keeps your brain from shutting down and giving up. So do yourself a favor. Get a hearing test now. Thank you for watching our video. And remember, if you want to keep up to date, scan the QR code or click subscribe.